Hey guys, it's Worker Brothers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Quarterman, where last time off, he progressed through to the semi-final of the Champions League. After I beat Arsenal over the two legs in the quarterfinals. Now, as you can see, I'm about to play Chelsea in the semi-final of the FA Cup. I'll also have the first leg of my semi-final in the Champions League, which is against Seville, because why not? So yeah. Also, little interesting little tidbit there. The two players who were on display were Ramirez and I, both players who won't be at Liverpool and Chelsea respectively next season, in the next FIFA, because Ramirez of course left Chelsea back in January, and I just recently moved to Bournemouth.
Remembers the losers, and I've been on the end of losing situations, and you just do not want it. It's one of those days to forget, but a day to remember.
So,
playing Liverpool with great history of the fixture and some wonderful games in recent seasons as well between the two, when they've both been going for league titles. With a ghost goal at Anfield. Plenty of history between these two teams. Here's the Chelsea lineup. Thomas Kallas starts with Kamil Glick in central defence.
I'm sure in attack, Diego Costa starts. Most of you aren't here that. Not all of you.
This is the Liverpool side. Just to check on the formation. 4-4-2, but an interesting variation on it.
Turbe, I don't think he's going to get there ahead of Begovic any distance, but he did win the throw, which may lead to something. If I can get the throw to the player I wanted to, which I can't. Wait. No, I've been penalized for doing nothing. Oh, wait! Origi! Oh, Begovic screws up! Begovic screws up and Origi puts me in the lead. What a mistake.
A strike from the skipper. Yeah, he's popped up.
Begovic tries the simple pass to Kallas. And, it wasn't simple enough. That is, ladies and gentlemen, the problem with playing the ball short from a goal kick or a free kick in that general area. Stuff like that happens. So Chelsea, through pure stupidity, have gone 1-0 down in at the first 15 minutes.
To Moses. He's got his shot off now.
Oh, was this sculpture or the spectacular? It was never going to come off for him, let's be honest here. Brigitte's pass was intercepted. Oh, Begovic just got it. Away in time. If he had held on to it for a few more seconds, I might have made some contact with that and sent it in the correction.
Diego Costa. Victor Moses.
There is Azpilicueta, Chelsea.
Fabregas. Ramirez.
Seems to be a popular sign for Chelsea and for Mota. I hear people saying all the time about Alaba going to Juventus in every career mode, but Yolk goes to Chelsea in almost every career mode. Of course, he won't be able to go to Chelsea in FIFA 17 because he recently moved to Monaco. So, he won't be able to move.
Brilliant team play this. with the passing, the movement off the ball to make the passing possible.
That kick in the head. Although Alaba will still be able to move 2 minutes. Unless he moves in the remainder of the window. I mean, it's not like there's a team out there who can afford to buy Alaba. And that the Champions League is clearly doesn't matter anymore because guys like Ibrahimovic went to Manchester United. It's giving up the Champions League, and they might be, and United also might be about to sign Pogba, who again would be giving up the Champions League. They also have Mkhitaryan, who also gave up the Champions League. Just saying, you know, there's a team out there, I'm not going to name who they are, whose left back is terrible. Well, they really need a really good one. Like, you know, a 5-year-old would be better than the one they currently have. Well, that's a good block. The Alaba would be a really good choice. Just saying. They play in England. They wear red. I can't think of their name. But I think it starts with an L. Maybe I'm wrong. Pretty sure it starts and ends with an L. Who could that team be? Terrible current left back. Anyone could replace him, even me. Play in England. In the Premier League, their name starts and ends with L. For the life of me, I can't think of it. Something cool, maybe?
FA Cup semi-final second half has started.
Oh yeah, that's right. It's Liverpool.
45 minutes. This, if the first half's anything to go by.
No. Yeah, on that Jurgen Klopp. Stop going after 30-something centre backs, who I don't even know. Like, does anyone else know who this guy is, who Liverpool just signed? So, you're telling me Man United can go out and sign Ibrahimovic and Mkhitaryan? And Liverpool signed some 30-something centre-back who nobody has ever heard of in their life. I don't even know what nationality he is. I don't know who he is. I don't know who he is, and I don't care. He's not supposed to be who we signed. Are we trying to get worse? Like, are we trying to get to the point where... or we'll go the same way as Newcastle and Aston Villa? Is that what's going to happen? Because I can prevent myself from watching the crumbling in season we're about to have if that's the case. He's right now. I can tell myself specifically to not watch any game because if that's the best we're going to do, then we're absolutely fucked. We're going to sign a defender, for fuck's sake, sign a good one! And sign one that I've relatively heard of, or have absolutely heard of. I mean, there's a 19-year-old centre-back over in Germany who's just chilling, waiting to be signed because his team played even worse than Liverpool last season, and finished really low down in the Bundesliga. Huh? You could probably get him for next to nothing. Really good centre-back. I have him in my team. His name is Sewell. No one has signed him yet. Why has no one signed him yet? And there's another player for really young with a lot of potential who no one has signed yet. Tielemans! Why is no one going for Tielemans? I was expecting bids to be going into Anderlecht left, right, and center. He's not even in the news. There's not even news about him. One of the most used player in FIFA 16 career mode. I guarantee you everyone who plays career mode used Tielemans at least once. Because this is of how high potential he has. And he's very good in real life as well.
Chelsea running out of chances now.
Just ask Arsenal, because they played against Anderlecht. And Tielemans played very well against them. I don't understand it. I really don't.
Wilson. And that will end the threat, at least for the moment.
Maybe he's waiting for something? I don't know. But
Fabregas.
Whatever they're waiting for, it's not happening soon enough.
Origi. This could be a chance. And a go with the volley. Great stop.
One, yes. Wilson knocks it in. 3-0. Oh, we're on our way to the final. Oh, Wembley, don't go anywhere. Or, well, it can't. It's in the stadium.
Who didn't react as quickly as the goal scorer.
But, yeah. We'll be back in about a month or so. We'll play either Arsenal or Manchester United. Whichever team wins the other semi-final.
Ramirez. Liverpool will get
the... We will have to wait and see. But, in this dominating performance, in the dominating performances I've had against Arsenal and United in the league this season, and not just the league for Arsenal, and not just the league for United either, because I came up against them in the Capital One Cup, knocked them out of it.
That's a free kick awarded here.
Memories of earlier this season.
That's Aspilicueta. He's got that through clever reading of the...
There's the full-time whistle. It was academic. It was 3-0 with spare time left. A brace from Divock Origi. He had a third goal from Sam Wilson. Give me the victory that I was looking for. Or which means I await the winner of Manchester United and Arsenal. The only problem is I have to await. But it's okay. Simulation happens pretty quickly. It happens relatively quickly, anyway. Okay, so, there we go. There's the, confirmation that the, and I saw who won. The, news revealed it to me. Arsenal. Arsenal won 3-0 as well. So I'll be facing Arsenal again in the FA Cup. Fair enough. I will see you who at Wembley, Arsene Wenger. Perfect. No, I don't want to be any international manager. What the fuck is a manager? Quickly sim this game against Crystal Palace. It doesn't matter, I have won the league. Hey, they beat me, fair enough. Good on you, Crystal Palace. It doesn't fucking matter. Yep, see. It's two games, dude. Dude, calm the shit down. Origi picked up, Neymar picked up a booking in the second leg against Arsenal, which means he can't play in this match. Yes, he is. He's my starting center back. One of my two starting center backs. And I don't play him for two games, and suddenly he's bitching and moaning. I mean, he's played, I'd say, 96% of the matches this season. And that sounds like an estimate that I pull out of my ass, but it has to be close to that, because he's played almost every single match except the odd cup match and the odd league match. So the fact that he's bitching and moaning, he shouldn't be bitching and moaning. Frickin'. Anyway, let's get into this second final match. But pretty much my first team, minus his Neymar, who can't play because of suspension. And yes, my first team does include you, Uvarang, you freaking idiot. Is your semi-final now? Nope, it isn't. Of course it isn't.
We are getting towards the business end of the Champions Cup. Here we are.
Let's do this.
It's a nervous time because you've come so far, you've worked so hard, you don't want to blow it now.
Our main game today features Sevilla play Liverpool. This is the Sevilla lineup for this game. Thibaut Courtois starts in goal. Daniel Carrizo starts. He's back from suspension.
Coutinho. Can't find anyone with the pass. Brilliant. Great start.
For Liverpool. Ricardo Rodriguez starts with Nathaniel Klein as the wide defenders. Gareth Bale starts with Marco Reus in the wide.
We're passed by Tielemans to Reus. Find the space. Ah, oh, the deflection. I'll take the corner, though. I will take a corner. No one can get to it, though. No one can get to it, so it's a Seville throw.
And it's Reyes.
Great steal by Tielemans. He's got the being of Coke.
He
oh, he goes past him again for a good measure. Origi buries it. Team Walker. Iggy. He in the first. He for the first time in about 5 years. I'm exaggerating, it's been about 3 seasons since he was in the first team.
Well, let's take another
Yeah. Look at that. Great finish from Divo Origi. And it's the second star who's shining brighter than the first tier. In this early stages of this semi-final, if you will. So, unless you're booking him, referee, you're not booking him, so you should have let me play on. I could easily gotten to that with Cristiano Ronaldo. Do you not know how fast Cristiano Ronaldo is? Clearly not.
Cristiano Ronaldo goes in and gets the ball.
Here's Cristiano Ronaldo. Ah!
Benoit Tremoulinas. Okay. Steven.
Yeah, decent enough.
Reyes. This attack from Sevilla.
So I can, he's similar, it's second one. One that was not good enough. One is not good enough. Ooh, good save.
Sevilla.
From the against the former Arsenal man, yes.
Tries to punch it away. Well, they just can't get the ball away.
I was kind of hoping he would punch it, forward. But, out for another corner is okay, I guess. As long as they don't score for this more, which they are not going to do. Okay, go Coutinho. Or go Rodriguez, go! Go! You can run an ounce later.
And they talk of him taking on some international commitments as well.
Interesting, but he's clearly a talented club manager now.
Royce!
Oh! The deflection prevents... probably 2-0. Oh, Ronaldo! Another deflection!
99 times out of 100.
And you know, the deflections are sick. Even their hides here in Seville. From the header? Yes. Nathaniel Klein. Go, Nathaniel, go! Go, 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 go!
Too easy for him. Poor defending that.
Coutinho. Royce! Another deflection! Are you kidding me?
And the goalkeeper coming off his line.
Bale. Rain. Can you get an assist? Both Bale and Coutinho left it for no freaking reason! I have to take a yellow card to prevent the counter-attack. Right? That was not a red card! That was not a red card! Oh, screw you, you biased cunt! Oh, make it... wear white, don't ya? Wear white, because you're clearly on their side. Mr. That's a cunt. Yeah, blow the whistle, I was right outside the box. Box. You know, learn the rules! Us. What complete bullshit.
And it's off and running for the second half of the Champions Cup semi-final.
Well, we're getting to the point now where nobody can afford to make a mistake.
Hey, can't let it affect me. Ronaldo. Straight away. Oh my god, their defense is all over. Is everywhere. Do they have like 10 defenders or some shit? Because it seems like everywhere I go there's a defender or at least a Seville player in my way. I know they have more players now, but if that was the case before the bullshit red card.
Well, the player that we're featuring here has done well. He's certainly been an influence on this first half.
Well, he played really well, didn't he? And he got himself a goal.
Great challenge by Aymeric Laporte. Loses it straight away as soon as I said something. Oh, thank Christ. I don't know why they're making a substitution. It should really be me making a substitution. All my best players are on the pitch. Foul! Foul! Are you paying attention? Does he have to literally take me out for you to give a foul? You stupid cunt.
Peter out that attack, it's the goalkeeper's ball quite easily.
Yeah, another paid for referee. Go Ronaldo, go! Go!
Yet another corner.
Wins another corner.
Check on the corner count.
I'm surprised it's only 5. I thought I'd be up to 10 by now with all the deflections and shit. Yes! Origi! Easy goal! 2-0! Oh, suck on that, Seville, and your BS! That is exactly what you deserve. Your keeper hits it straight at Ronaldo, falls to Origi, and he scores his 9th of the competition. And you can go suck off your paid-for referee. He can't stop up my hey, class.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0. Eva Banega. in goes the cross.
Easy ball from my keeper. Go. Go, Klein, go. I wasn't gonna get there. Move faster, Gareth, for fuck's sake.
Eva Banega.
Great block by Nathaniel Klein. At the expense of a corner, I will let them have as many corners as they want because they go straight to my keeper. Go. Go. Make a run for fuck's sake. Riggy, who's on a hat trick? Hey. Off the post. Off the post, but Cristiano Ronaldo does the business. 3-0. Oh. And Seville, you have absolutely no one to blame but yourself because you know what this is called? Karma. And it's a bitch.
To be honest with you, Martin, the opposition looks down and out down there.
You pay off a referee, you should get exactly what you deserve.
Coutinho. Well, you can see what he was trying to. He might be through.
Oh, go on, Cristiano. Ah!
And it's Reyes.
I forgot they defend with 10 men in front of the keeper.
Gareth Bale.
Practically gives me no space unless I hit him on the counter attack. Go, go, Gareth. Go!
Ball deserved perhaps a better response from his teammates in the middle.
Nathaniel Klein! Why did I shoot? What was I expecting to happen?
Let's take another look, Alan, at Cristiano Ronaldo's goal. We're down now to the final 2 minutes of the 90. Reyes. We're hearing there will be 3 added minutes here. Eva Banega.
Way wide of the mark. Which, you know what that means? This should be the last kick of the game. The referee isn't going to blow the whistle, no? Okay, there it is. Thank you, you corrupt piece of shit. Now get the hell out of here. Even with a corrupt referee against me, I am the boss. Isn't he one for the future? That's fantastic to know. Well, he must be having a whale of a time down in the championship. Yeah, I'm ignoring all these transfer requests. They don't really mean anything to me. To the next game. Unless I come up against them at some point next season, and it'll be my last game against Middlesbrough for a while. Do the business, boys. Thank you, Wilson. Iturbe and Ari. He banging in the goals against my own keeper, because that keeper is on loan for me. but semantics. But obviously he's terrible. He couldn't keep them up, which means he's not good enough to be my keeper. So yeah, he won't be at Liverpool. Will come to the end of the next transfer window. So, well, I will 100% be selling him. You are a secondary player. You have no right to be asking for more playing time because you're getting plenty. Okay, so Barcelona await me in the final. It doesn't say that they are, but they beat Chelsea over the two legs 3-2. And it's Wolfsburg versus Valencia in the final of the Europa League. Interesting matchup. Germany vs. Spain. Not an uncommon matchup by any stretch of the imagination. And yeah, a 3-0 up. I'm relatively confident. Yep, as I should be. They didn't even score a goal. Oh, 2-0, Cristiano Ronaldo and Nathaniel Clyne. That's a few goals Nathaniel Clyne's gotten in the Champions League now. Because he scored against Arsenal as well. Both of his goals came in the second leg as well. How bad is it? 7 days. So there's pretty much nothing wrong with him. Did his lines go up? I think he went up. He's 86 for him now. Fantastic. Well done. And Dermans, for a new game, he's suspended with what you up to an 86. Hector would have gotten you suspended sooner. I mean, look at that. That's just mad. And yet, nothing. In real life. No, he's not. So, I'm going to end this episode here. In the next episode, I will have the last games of this season against Arsenal and Barcelona. There will be a final league game against Spurs in between. But I've already won the league, so... not important. Of course, I gotta confirm my victories in the FA Cup and the Champions League. So, yeah. Until next time, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Hit subscribe. Hope for more videos very, very soon. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.